Mr. Shammi, and this is?
Daniel.
Yes, and today we are going to have a fun quiz session for you. So all set for the fun? The first one. The first challenge is how long can you concentrate on a point? And what we are going to do, Rania, we are going to look at the tip of the nose. Now we have to check who is going to blink the eye first. Whoever blinks the eye is the loser. Okay, let's start. So, very softly, you will bring your attention at the tip of the nose and keep gazing at that. Don't stare. Softly keep gazing at the tip of the nose. So, sit straight and we're starting now. Time starts now. Oh, so like I did for 27 counts, maybe 27 seconds, and Rania approximately did that. The next challenge is you're looking in between your eyebrows. Let's do that, and again, whoever blinks first is going. Yes. Take your spine, sit straight. Close your eyes and very softly open and bring your attention in between your eyebrows. Okay, 10 count. So, you know, when we do that regularly and when you're doing it like maybe once or twice a day, or when you are all set to study and when you do that for maybe like 2 minutes, you see you will really do well because you are bringing all your attention at one point and then going for study. So, you're sure you're going to do that, right? Okay, what next, Rania? What do we do next?
How about balance and posture?
Okay, so we are going to do Garudasana. You know what is Garuda? So, Garuda is a Sanskrit word and Garuda means eagle. So, we are going to do eagle pose and that's a balancing posture. Let's get on the mat. Standing position. How do we start? Hands on the waist. Softly bend your knees. And then, I'm just lifting my right foot off the floor, bringing it to the left side and wrapping it around my other bent knee. I'm trying to lock my calf, the left calf with the right toe. And once this is done, I'm trying to get my body straight. It needs a lot of concentration. Softly. And once you're done with that, this is what you're going to do. And arm up. See, looking at Rani, I started losing balance. And now she's doing it so well. So if you can lift your hands up, you really have to focus at one point, and when you do that, you can actually hold this posture for some time, and it's very good for improving your concentration, and you will excel everywhere. So, we're going with the other leg. Again, bend your knee softly. Let me check how Rania is doing. Okay, she has bent her knees. She's lifting her left foot off the floor, wrapping it around the other leg. So, she is stabilizing herself in the posture. Eyes are fixed at one point in front and only take your time. So, you know, when you do that, you actually end up developing a lot of concentration. It's absolutely fine if you cannot hold it for a long time. Keep coming back to this. Yes. Yes. It's okay. So, this is what you'll have to do. Practice it until you can actually balance for like 5 to 10 seconds. The next one. Can we have a few things from nature, Rania?
Yes.
So, say two postures which are inspired by nature.
The tree one and the mountain.
Okay. So, we are going to be the tree and the mountain. So, let's see how does the tree look and how does the mountain look in the posture. Hands on the waist. And again, you are shifting your body weight on the left leg completely and bend your right knee softly. Now, keeping your eyes fixed at one point, get your right foot off the floor, bring it at the root of the left leg. As I can see, Rania is hurrying up and she lost the balance. See, all the balancing postures needs a lot of concentration. And now she will do it really well. She has started focusing at one point. Yeah, she's good. I'm good too. Namaste. And if you're still comfortable, go up. And if you want to stretch more, interlace your finger, further go up. Rania, come on, let's do it again. You also have to do. Come on, Rania, let's do it with the other leg. Come on. So we're doing it with the other leg. No laughing, we have to do the posture. So we're starting with the other leg again. One step at a time. See, looking at her, I'm losing balance. Huh? See, this way. Tall. Palms in namaste. Hold your tummy tight. And up. This way. And release. So when you do this posture, and these are the balancing postures, you really need to focus a lot. So go very slowly. So next, you wanted to be a mountain. Let's see, how can I make Rania a mountain? Rania, how will you, if I tell you, Rania, be a mountain, what will you do? You don't know? Let's try. So we are going to do a mountain pose. Some of the yoga schools, they also call it Adho Mukha Svanasana or dog pose. So what we are going to do, go this way. See, we start from here, this way. And then we get the knees off the floor, this way. And push the body weight at the back. So let me see what Rania is doing. Does she look like a mountain? See, she is a mountain. Come on, mountain. You can climb on the mountain. See, this is mountain pose. And when you do that, because you guys are sitting for a long time while studying, all this area becomes very tight. So that's why she's not able to get her heels on the floor. So when you do this posture regularly, you will start opening up your hamstrings and your heels will start coming down like this. So this is the mountain pose. Try and get your chest in. Yeah. So you can feel a lot of opening. It is very tight. That's why it's not opening. But when you do it very regularly, you will start opening your legs. Your arms will become very strong and you will become very strong. Relax, come back. So, our first posture was balancing posture. The second was inspired by nature. What next? How about animal?
Yes.
Yeah. Which animal do you like?
Lion.
Oh.
Can we do lion posture?
Oh, she likes lion and we are going to do a lion posture now. So, we will sit comfortably. You can, if you know Padmasana, you can sit in Padmasana. Otherwise, no problem. You can sit in any posture. Do you know Padmasana, Rania?
Yes.
Let's do Padmasana. Rania knows how to do Padmasana. So, this way. See, if you have any pain in your knee, please don't do Padmasana. You can sit comfortably. Okay? So, we are in Padmasana. Now, we are moving to lion posture. Because Rania loves lion. So, we are going to be lions now. So, what we are going to do, we will shift our body weight in front. So hands are by the side of your knees. Shift and come on the knees. This is challenging, but you can do it. And now we are moving the palms forwards like really like a lion. And move your hips in front, chest up. See, this is the posture which a lion assumes before attacking the prey. So tall, chest up. And because we are lion, we are also going to? Yes. So inhale. When you exhale, get your tongue out. You are trying to touch your chin and create sound as loud as you can. So start. Inhale. Ah! I could do it longer than Rania. Come back. Now the lion will love me. Come back. And release. And relaxed. Slowly. Whenever you are sitting in Padmasana, it's very important you stretch your legs and very slowly give a good massage to your knees. This way. Do you know any asana name? Have you heard of any asana name?
Yes, I have. I have heard of bow and plow pose.
Oh, those are really classical postures. Have you ever done it?
No, but I can try it.
Bow. So, let's be a bow. And Rania is going to be a bow and we are going to have good fun with bow Rania. So, you will lie down on your tummy for bow pose on your tummy. Tummy. She is lying down on the tummy. Now she is going to bend her knees. And hold the right ankle with the right hand and the left ankle with the left hand. Now first thing she has to do, she has to get her heels away from the hips first and then the legs, the thighs off the floor. And once she's very comfortable, she has to get the upper part of the body. As much as possible, keep pulling it up. So this is called a bow posture. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to have a good fun with Rana. So look, see, this movement. And what am I, get your knees together, see, and hold your legs tightly. So what am I going to do with Rana now? See, I'm going to lift her and move her this way. So relax, you're okay? So when you do that, you have a very strong back, you end up with a very strong back, your arms become very strong, and it is good fun, you know. When you're playing with your brothers and sisters or your mom and dad, you can lift. Make sure when you drop, don't just drop it, just place it down on the floor, whoever you're lifting to. And Rania spoke about plow pose. So we are going to do a plow pose, and that's also a very interesting posture. So what we are going to do, lie down on your back. Legs straight, hands by the side of the body, now legs up and bring your legs over your head. Yes, she could do it. So if she interlocks her finger, see, so she can pull it out and she can push the feet out completely. See, this is a plow pose. You know, the peasants and all, they use plow for farming. So you can always look at the picture and see this is how it is done. Now let's do some masti, some fun. See, Rana is bending her knees and knees are close to the ears, and she will be folding her hands on the thigh. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to roll her over. How? See, we are having fun this way. And I think all the kids love backbend. When you do backbend, you become very strong. So the first backbend we are going to do from the floor. So Rania, do your backbend from the floor. How do we start it? We lie down on the floor, we bend the knees and bring the heels close to the hips. Next, we place the palms by the side of the head. Now, make sure that you don't hold your hair, otherwise you won't be able to go up. So she has very smartly got the hair out and the fingers are facing the body. First step, get your hips up and then head up. Look at her, see? And if you want, you can play around, and you can come from here. See this way. See. Look at her. See? And come down. That was really good, huh? And you will have a very strong back. And you know, unlike the old people who keep complaining of back pain, you will never get back pain. Now, Rania is going to do back bend again, but this time from standing position. And when you are trying to do from standing position, the back bend, the chakrasana, don't do it independently if you are not used to. Ask your parents to stand by the side of you and help you. So I'm not going to hold Rania because I know she does it pretty well. So we are just going to look into her standing chakrasana. Go. See. And I'm sure many of you can do that. Now she can also come back like that. Come back, Rania. Yes. And once more, and this time we are going to add some more fun to that. Go back and walk in all the directions possible. See. Yes. She's going forward, she's going backward, she's going side. And come back slowly. Yes, and relax. I mean, this is really not that easy. Huh? She's relaxing, just calm down. Important you relax after your chakrasana, so that if there is any stress which would have come in the back, you should release this. Rania, do you like geometry?
Yes.
So we are planning, or let's have one asana with geometric shape.
Okay.
Which one do you want?
Rectangle.
Oh, you like rectangle so much?
Yes.
Okay, so let's do rectangle with the wall. And see, this is like, she is going to show you how super Rania is, like a Spider-Man. Come on. So Rania is in Parvatasana or Adho Mukha Svanasana, which we did, but her feet is on the wall now. And what next she is going to do? She is going to walk on the wall. See, is this a rectangle? Does it look like a rectangle? Very much. Rania, get your head in, look at the toes. Very nice. Look at the core. She's going to have flat abs. If you want that flat abs, do this one. If you want strong arms, do that. You can come down whenever you feel like and relax. So that was a rectangle on the wall. And if you're comfortable with rectangle, you can actually stick to the wall. But please take precautions. Make sure when you're doing these things, get your parents to be standing by the side of you. Don't do it alone if you're not used to. Don't get hurt, please. Next one is really interesting one. And what we are going to do, we are going to do handstand. You want to try that, Rania? Okay, let's try. So again, she is going to do Parvatasana over here. You can go there. So let's see. Not bad. Yes. Yes. I'm helping Rania. Not bad. And you can come down. One leg down and the other leg down. Okay. So what you can do when you're practicing, you can go like how Rania went, or you can go with one leg. So Rania, just come here. Let me just show. So you can be like, you can just have fun time. I'm sure you must be doing it. Arms up, down and up. You can go like this if you want to. You can stand there. And then you can come down with one leg this way. Remember, you're not doing it alone. You have to get your parents by the side of you and then you do it. And maybe your parents can help you if you're not used to, like how I helped Rania, because Rania is not used to doing that. So maybe if I can just help a few more times, she will do it immediately and so will you. So just do it and see how does it feel. End of the session. And how are we going to end? Of course with a lot of fun, because we have been doing a lot of fun. So how are we going to end it? We are going to lie down on the tummy and become a snake. But this snake is also likes to watch TV. So what are we going to do? We are lying down on the tummy. You can keep doing this. This is very relaxing. It will release all the tension from the back, especially because you are sitting for so many hours and study. So do that. Keep enjoying the session. Go with your friends, your family, with your brother, your sister, and we will meet you again. Thank you.